Hello, this is chapter 9, end of chapter problem. See, so problem number 1, they are giving us 10 years of annual growth rate of GDP for 10 years for a country. So let us take a look at this. So this, you see, the first 3 years is first year growth rate 5%, then 3%, then 4%, then minus 1, minus 2, and then the last 5 year is again positive growth rate. See, so now let us answer the questions. What is the country's trend growth rate, which means the average long-term growth rate? So to get that, we will add up all of them and then divide with 10, because we have 10 years of data. Please note that in between we have what? For the third year we have minus 1 growth rate, and fourth year we have minus 1, and for the fifth year again we have minus 2. So there we have negative growth rate for those two. So that they represent recession. We know that already. So we now take the average of 10 year and then get the trend growth rate, the long run growth rate, as 2.7%. Now the next question is, what set of years most clearly demonstrate an expansionary phase of circle? So this will be the last 5 years, right? Last 5 years, look at that, I have highlighted. So they have what? 5 years of positive growth rate. And then, but there is another shorter, the first 3 years, again, positive growth rate. So out of these two, we know the larger, longer expansionary phase is the last 5 years, because we have positive growth rate in each year for the last 5 years. Now, the next thing is which set of years best illustrate a recessionary phase for this cycle? We know that the fourth year and fifth year, those 2 years, they have recession, right? Negative growth rate. So that will be the answer. Now let us say question, we have this question number 2, and this is telling us we have total population of country 500 million, and then population under 16 is 120 million, then labor for not in labor force 150 million, unemployed is 23 million, and then part-time workers looking for full-time jobs is 10 million. So what is the size of the labor force? The first thing they want to know. We know that labor force include this unemployed labor and employed labor, those two components in the labor force. And then we also know that if we take this total population and then subtract this population under 16 years of age or institutionalized, and also subtract not in labor force, this one, and subtract unemployed, those three things, we will get the labor force. So this is what they are doing here. So they take this, the size of the labor force, they take this 500 is the total population, 120 is population, is this one, population under 16 years, and then 120 is not in labor force, and then we have, so 500 minus 120 minus 150, and then that will be the size of the labor force. And then we, to get the unemployment rate, we will divide the unemployed labor force, this is 23, divided by total labor force, which is 230. So 23 divided by 230 will be, this will give us 10%. So that will be the unemployment rate for this country, given this information. And this part, part-time workers looking for full-time jobs, this 10, this one is what? This one is already included, not in the labor force. So we don't have to account for that separately. See, then problem number three, they are telling us that suppose in this country unemployment rate, the natural rate of unemployment, the NRU is 5%. So this is the long run unemployment rate, right? NRU. And they tell us that the actual rate of unemployment is 9%. So we know that the actual unemployment rate include three types of unemployment: the frictional unemployment, the structural unemployment, and the cyclical unemployment. So all together 9%. And then the natural rate of unemployment, NRU, that include only two types of unemployment: the frictional unemployment and the structural unemployment. Therefore, the difference between NRU and the 5% and actual unemployment rate 9% will be 4%. That 4% will be what? Will be the cyclical unemployment rate. This is what they show us, the cyclical. And then we can use the Okun's law and find out that if the cyclical unemployment is 4%, then the GDP gap for this country will be twice that. So 8%, right? So 2 times 4% is 8% GDP gap. And now they also tell us that potential GDP is 500 billion for this country. So 500 billion, and if you take 8% of that 500 billion is 40 billion. So GDP gap, the output foregone GDP gap is $40 billion because of that unemployment. See, this is the output that those unemployed labor could have produced if they were employed. And this is a loss to the society, and this can never be regained. Now, this is the next question, question number 4 from chapter 9. This is problem number 4, chapter 9. And then this is, they say that CPI for a country was 110 last year, and this year it is 121. So see, CPI has increased from 110 to 121 last year to between last year and this year. So we can find out inflation by calculating the percentage, right, in change. So the inflation rate was 10%. So 121 minus 110 divided by 110 and then multiplied by 100. So that will be what? That will be the inflation rate for this country. And now the next thing is what? If the CPI was 110 last year and in one is 108 this year. So this is another example. They say CPI has decreased from 110 last year to 108 this year. So what will be the deflation? We know that when general price level decreases, that is deflation, right? So we do the calculation and we find out that CPI has decreased by 1.8%. See? So that is what? That is question number 4. That is problem number 4. Now let us go to problem number 5, end of chapter 9. So this one tells us that how long would it take for the price level of a country to double if inflation is 2% in part A, part B is 5%, part C is 10% per year. We know that to find out how long it will take for inflation to double, so we have to use the rule of 70, right? Rule of 70 says that years to double is equal to 70 divided by that inflation rate that is given. So for part A, for this one, for example, it is saying 2% inflation. So if you divide 70, in the rule of 70, if you divide 70 with that 2% inflation rate, the answer is 35, right? So it will be 35 years. Then if you are considering part B, where inflation is 5%, so 70 divided by what? 70 divided by 5%, so there is a typo. 70 divided by 5 is what? Is 14. So 14 years, it will take 14 years for the price level to double. And then the last one is what? If inflation rate in part C is 10% per year, so use rule of 70, and put that 10% inflation rate here, 70 divided by 10 is what? 7 years. So then it will, in part C, it will take 7 years for inflation rate to double. This is chapter 9, end of chapter, problem 6. And here they are saying that suppose nominal income increases by 5.3% and price increases by 3.4% in some year in a country. So what percentage would your real income approximately increase? So to find the answer, we have to look in the formula that is given in the slides and in the book. Percentage change in real income is given is equal to percentage change in nominal income, which in this example is 5.3, minus inflation, which is in a, given as 3.8. So the difference between those two is what? Is 1.5. So that will be the percentage change in real income. Now we can also rearrange the equation above as follows. Inflation rate equal to percentage change in nominal income minus percentage change in real income. See, we just take this inflation rate on the left hand side. So from negative it becomes positive here, and then percentage change in real income, if we take it to the other side, so it becomes negative. So now we can calculate, we can find out the answer for second part. If your nominal income increased by 2.8 and your real income increased by 1.1, so this percentage change in nominal income is 2.8 and this percentage change in real income is what? 1.1. And then the difference between those two is inflation rate, right? Inflation rate is what? Inflation rate is 1.7. So that is approximately that is the answer. Thank you. So this is problem number 7, chapter 9, and here they are telling us that the nominal rate of inflation is 4% and the inflation premium is 2% in a country, right? What is the real interest rate? We know that real interest rate is given by this formula. This is formula is given in the book and in the slide. So nominal interest rate minus inflation premium, the difference between those two, real interest rate. So we substitute the values and find out that nominal interest rate is 4% and then inflation premium 2%. So the difference is 2%. That will be the real interest rate. And now we can rearrange this formula and then get from there we can get this one. Inflation premium equal to nominal interest rate minus interest rate. So if we now use the alternately assume the real interest rate is 1% and nominal interest rate is 6%. So substitute the values, nominal interest rate 6%, real interest rate 1%. So the inflation premium, the difference between those two will be what? The difference implies the inflation premium is 5%.